one of the questions I'll often get as a Lutheran pastor is, why do we baptize babies? It's a good question. And let me give you a fourfold response, four reasons for why we do. First, who does the work? Second, the punishment of sin is death. Third, it's included in the scriptures. And fourth, it was the practice of the early church. So let's start at the top. Who does the work? If baptism is man's work, if it's my acknowledgement of my faith, a public confession, then those churches who don't baptize babies are right. But we don't view it as our work. We view it as God's work, something he does for us, a gift he gives. 1 Peter 3:21, baptism, which corresponds to this, now saves you. The correspond part is the immediate text before, as Peter was talking about how God saved Noah and his family through the waters on the ark. And so God now uses baptism, the waters of baptism, to save us. It's God's command. It's also God's gift. Second, the punishment of sin is death. Romans chapter 6, verse 23, Paul writes, "The wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is everlasting life in Christ Jesus our Lord." That's a wonderful truth, but we know the first part, the punishment of sin, the wages of sin is death. My wife and I have had a miscarriage. We've lost a child, and we grieve that. But our children are sinners. They die because they sin. And so they need a Savior just as much as you need a Savior, just as much as I need a Savior. And thanks be to God, Jesus died on the cross to give them the same salvation he died to give to you and me. Third, it's included in Scripture. So we have the Great Commission. Go therefore, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. All nations does not exclude children, right? But also, and maybe larger connection here, is the idea of circumcision. In the Old Covenant, if you wanted to be part of God's kingdom, you had to be circumcised. And so on the eighth day of a boy's life, his parents would have him circumcised. They would also name him on that day. So circumcision was the entry. And no eight-day-old boy was begging his parents to be circumcised. Just didn't happen. Now, we don't have to be circumcised any longer. But for the new covenant, baptism is the entry point. See the connection? We don't have to ask for baptism. We don't have to ask to be part of God's kingdom. It's a gift. It's given to us. Fourth, I said it's going to be the idea that it was the practice of the early church. Largely every Christian was baptized, even their children, all the way up until really the time of the Reformation. There's some great church father quotes. There was one where Fetus is rejected by Cyprian of Carthage, who said Fetus wanted to wait until the eighth day to make that connection to circumcision clear in the covenants. And Cyprian responded that no one in the church agreed with his position. No man born ought to be denied baptism. So who does the work? It's in the scriptures. Punishment of sin is death. Early church did it. We baptize our kids because it's a gift.